Hello, this is Chun VR. For those of you who are waiting for the AX210 chip test, I have posted an update on the community tab, so please refer to it. Anyway, today I'm gonna check the Quest Pro's PCVR local dimming feature. Hey nerd, what is the local dimming? Local dimming is a technology that improves black expression and contrast ratio by increasing blank level. If you are not sure what this means, you should take a look at both axes of display technology, LCD and OLED. The difference between LCD and OLED is the presence or absence of a backlight. LCD use a backlight to emit light on the display, while OLED use organic materials that can emit light on their own without a backlight. The O in OLED stands for organic, which means organic matter. The biggest difference that having a backlight makes is black. LCD displays black by using the backlight, which results in a somewhat hazy and grayish black color. On the other hand, OLED can display pure black by turning off the individual pixels. In conclusion, LCD displays have weakness in representing black colors. Local dimming is a technology used to compensate for LCD's weakness in representing black colors. This technology uses a backlight called mini-LED, which is a dense array of small LEDs grouped into blocks called dimming zone. The light in this dimming zone is turned up to represent black, similar to OLED. For the professional-grade monitors, there are more than 2,000 dimming zones, while for the Quest Pro, there are 500 dimming zones. However, the Quest Pro didn't have local dimming enabled at launch, even though it had mini-LED. To be precise, developers had to do additional development to enable local dimming in their apps. Only few like Demel, The Light Brigade, Red Matter 2, and Gods of Gravity actually did. Quest Pro's local dimming is processing 500 dimming zones in real time, which requires additional processing power. This is probably why Meta don't apply local dimming globally in standalone mode. PCVR, on the other hand, is relatively free from these restrictions, so I've been thinking it would be a good fit. And finally, with the version 51 update, Quest Pro's PCVR has local dimming enabled by default. So, is local dimming all good? Not really. Unlike OLED, which can turn off individual pixels, local dimming turns off sections of the screen called dimming zones. But controlling these zones isn't always easy and not accurate, and that can cause the blooming effect, also known as the halo effect. You will notice it especially when there are bright objects on a black background. The blooming effect can be reduced with more dimming zones, and professional-grade monitors often feature over 2,000 dimming zones, resulting in a contrast ratio that rivals OLED display. So, Quest Pro has 500 dimming zones, which are considering pretty decent, although not the best. We will examine the effectiveness of Quest Pro's local dimming and whether it will have any side effects such as blooming or reduced brightness. We will also compare it to PSVR 2, which uses an OLED display. Anyway, some of you may be wondering, what is that PCVR2 Alex? Unfortunately, it is not the PCVR2 version Alex. I ran the PC version of Alex and connected the PCVR2 to the PC.
PCVR2 connected to PC?
Yes. However, I didn't come up with the PC driver for the PCVR2. I simply connected the PCVR2 to my PC with an adapter so that it would be recognized as a monitor. This adapter is a BizLink adapter and is sold by Barrio and Xstar. And I have a Barrio Arrow, so I had this adapter so I could test it. As you can see, the local dimming of the Cast Pro produces much deeper blacks than before, which I'm very happy with. The limit of 500 local dimming zones can result in some blooming when there are many bright objects on dark background. But personally, it didn't really bother me. I believe Cast Pro is undervalued compared to how good it is. But while Cast Pro does use local dimming, it seems difficult for its blank level and color to surpass the OLED used in PCVR2. However, due to the limitations of the PS5's 2070s graphic class, which is relatively lower compared to high-performance PCs, and the clarity of the Cast Pro's pancake lens, I feel that the Cast Pro outperforms the PCVR2 in overall graphics quality. It's clear that the Cast Pro has a slightly less sharpness than the Arrow due to compression artifacts. However, with the addition of local dimming, I feel like it's closer to the Arrow, which has the best sharpness of any consumer device on the market. The difference in detailed sharpness feels like it's more than offset by the many strengths of the Cast Pro. We've been testing out the local dimming feature of Cast Pro. That's it for today's video. See you in the Wi-Fi 6E test video. Thank you!